The next maximum performance maneuver to learn is the soft field takeoff. The objective of a soft field takeoff is to get the airplane flying as quickly as possible to eliminate the retarding force of mud, sand, high grass, snow, or other soft surfaces. You can use the same technique for rough fields to minimize damaging the landing gear. During a soft field takeoff, you want to get the airplane's weight carrying capability moved from the wheels to the wings as soon as possible. You do this by establishing and maintaining a nose-high pitch attitude by use of elevator control during the takeoff roll. As in a short field takeoff, flaps should be set as recommended by the manufacturer prior to starting the takeoff roll. After your run-up, once you start to taxi, keep moving so you don't get bogged down in the soft surface. Once lined up for departure, apply takeoff power. As the airplane accelerates, apply enough back elevator pressure to maintain a positive angle of attack and keep the weight off the nose wheel. In this attitude, the airplane will fly itself off the ground. It will also lift off and fly at a slower airspeed than you are accustomed to. This is due to what is called ground effect. What happens when flying very close to the ground is that you get a slight increase in lift. This is due to a reduction in induced drag caused by the effect the ground has on the flow of air along the wing. A good rule of thumb is that ground effect extends up to a height above the ground equal to your airplane's wingspan. For the Skycatcher, the wingspan is about 30 feet. So, roughly, when flying within 30 feet of the ground, you will be in ground effect.
Once flying, and while just above the ground, slowly lower the pitch attitude of the nose with the elevator and let the airplane accelerate to the best angle of climb speed if you have to clear obstacles. If no obstacles are in the way, accelerate to the best rate of climb speed. Don't attempt to fly out of ground effect before the best angle of climb speed is reached. If you do so, the greater induced drag upon leaving ground effect may cause the airplane to settle back to the ground. Once you have established best rate of climb speed and reached a safe maneuvering altitude, then slowly raise the flaps.
Recall that during a soft field takeoff, you want to get the airplane's weight carrying capability moved from the wheels to the wings as soon as possible.
But when doing a soft field landing, the objective is to have the wings support the airplane's weight as long as practical before transferring it to the wheels. By doing this, you allow the airplane's forward speed to decrease so that when you do touch down, you can do so gently at minimum speed. This reduces the stress caused by the soft field on the landing gear as well as the whole airplane. When making a soft field landing, the approach can be similar to what you would use for a long, hard field landing. Use flaps as recommended by the airplane manufacturer. You can use the same final approach speed for a soft field landing as you did for the short field landing. Also, you don't have to descend as steeply unless you have the old theoretical 50-foot high obstacle in the way. After the roundout, fly the airplane just above the surface at 1 or 2 feet. Do this as long as practical so you can be as slow as possible at touchdown. Once down, hold the airplane in a nose-high attitude with full back elevator pressure. This is to help keep the nose wheel clear of the surface while you slow down. You don't want it to dig in and maybe nose the airplane over. Don't use the brakes. If the surface is really soft, it will stop you quick enough. In fact, you might even have to add power to keep moving and prevent becoming bogged down.
One last note of caution. We reviewed short field and soft field maximum performance takeoffs, but not short soft field techniques. They are not required by the Airman certification standards, but more importantly, you have control over the situation.
When faced with making a short, soft field takeoff and landing, don't
except under the most dire emergency situation. Exercise extreme caution and judgment. A short, soft field operation presents a very real hazard that you'll want to avoid whenever possible.